ගම්වල කොල්ලන්ටත් දැන් ඩේටා තියෙනවා. ඉතින් කියන්න තියෙන්නේ ගොසිපුයි ගොන් ඒවා බල බල ඉන්නේ නැතුව මොකක් හරි ඔළුවට වැදගත් දෙයක් බලන්න කියලා. Because there's two ways of doing it, right? You can watch all the shit on YouTube. Oh. And you can also, people have no excuse. People have no excuse. Machang me 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 vakaranda. But monohari ganagan na tuwa indahari mukakarikkare. People have no excuse.
Eda.
Okay, we have all the resources in the world.
Hi everyone, welcome to another episode of my podcast. I have a very special guest today, and I'm doing this very early. today, so I have Kamaj Silva from all the way from Toronto, Canada. Hi, Kamaj.
Hi, Mazan. How are you?
I'm good.
Ogalada seetala nane.
Nah. We are actually here. It's 8:15
a.m. Ah, in the morning. Oh, mara 8:15 p.m. So we are like literally 12 hours.
I'm actually talking to like back to the maybe past. No, you're still
past. I'm talking to the future.
I saw your video with the I was watching some of the Daiya show episodes. Randhir, then Vasti.
Thanks, buddy. Yeah, Masang, it was done. So I wanted to create. So when I started creating content, so I wasn't heavily into content. So for my like companies and businesses, I was creating content, but right. Not on like a personal level, right? So like when the whole like we'll talk about it later probably, but when the whole Dragons Den thing took off, right. I did a few speaking tours in Sri Lanka and stuff. So I kind of wanted to create content and, you know, build my like personal brand. But I wasn't sure what the right way to do it was. So like, because I have like two sides to me as well, right? Entertainment and the other side is like the more professional, which I don't deem really professional, because I mean like I'm like Lankavata professional, nah, but like sneaker industry is like, we don't call it a professional industry, right? Like we go in like sweatsuits to like meetings. So we're not like in sneakers, and that's the industry. Which is right, like Lankawe, right. They are like, okay, like you're a businessman, like why are you wearing like jeans and sneakers? I'm like, we're so far behind, like come on. So that's my flow. Like here, people most of the time they encourage you to, you know, have a personal brand and kind of, you know, do your own thing. Magene Lankawe eka apita tama set pela na tama. When you say business, people think it's a suit and tie and, you know, like prim and proper, right? So that's not what I follow.
Yeah, even here in Manila, that over the years, Majan, that it's changing. People are more getting more relaxed in the like office environment, becomes more relaxed. They don't expect you to like come in full suits and stuff, especially in a tropical place like this. I don't know why people wear like suits.
Yeah, we got it all wrong, bro. Like all of the sales guys, mata dukha hitena pau ara tie coat dagena ara auwe matang duk windena. Why can't they wear like a like t-shirt and jeans? I think some of the companies are actually like, maybe like I think like ad agencies and like more like tech companies, they are adapting to it, and like, and that's good. That's how it should be, right? It shouldn't be about how you dress or what you wear. It should be about what you know and like, you know,
right.
Can you get the job done at the end of the day, right?
Yeah.
Okay, guys, so I'll just continue the YouTube thing. I wanted to create like an entertainment element to me as well. And now I've started my podcast and like the second channel, which is like the kind of more professional, where I talk about myself, my journey, hustle, all that. And I bring in experts from like different fields and stuff. So it's like two avenues that clash, but it's two different audiences as well.
Mm. So I wanted to ask you this, you know, this COVID situation and everything, how is affecting over there?
So we are actually going back to normal. So phase one is done. Certain parks are open. And phase two, certain retail shops are open. We have like curbside pickup and all that. And certain restaurants, I think, are opening up pretty soon, where they'll limit the people they let into like the store or the restaurant at one given time. But things are relaxing.
Mm.
hopefully a second wave won't hit.
Yeah, here also a little bit. I went to work for like 3 days now. So
yeah,
but we are taking it kind of easy. So, but the restaurants are not open yet for dining. It's just takeaway.
But they say in the second wave they'll open like certain restaurants. But I don't know. It's not like confirmed yet.
Machang, how? I got to know you and you did that video with Big Doggy. Big Doggy is my homeboy because he's also from Nigambo.
That's how I discovered you as well. When you did the interview, I saw Big Doggy shared it and I'm like, okay, someone else has interviewed this guy, so let me go and check what it is. I'm like, okay, so this guy is like, I checked out a few of your like other stuff as well, right? Like when I listen to the interview, I'm like, okay, this guy is like creating like quality content, because you know, like when it comes to content in Sri Lanka, it's like all gossip and like Samita ke boyfriend ke na kata karte, and those are the ones that are getting that's getting hits, right? And you know, they are the popular YouTube channels. So I'm like, I always appreciate the underdog who's like doing quality content and you know putting out something positive to the world. So I'm like, okay, this guy sounds good, like. I should, and I think I commented on the video, right?
I checked out your videos and stuff. That's how I got to, you know, I wanted to talk to you. Let's talk.
Yeah.
So come on, tell me a little bit about your story, man. Way back in Sri Lanka and then going to Toronto.
So I think we kind of share similar backgrounds, because I don't know how old you are, but I think we're pretty much the same age. So I went to St. Thomas's. So Stigmata, Suresh and Tenny, they were in the same class as me. They're same batchmates. Right. And Andrew was 1 year older to us. Stigmata first drummer, Bertie. I don't know if you guys know him. He was like earlier days of like on stage and like Rock Cafe and all those stuff. Bertie Tama Kali drama. Bertie Tama drum set take Hamadam Khadan. He's so heavy, he breaks the drum set. So Bertie is a good friend of mine. So I when Stigmata and them were coming up, and when we were in school, I was pretty connected to the rock circuit, Kali Rock Saturday. Matakadabasa Rock Cafe. I don't know if you remember Rock Cafe in Kalpiti. So Stigmata gigs well to Mazang Api Hamo Manway college called Lutican, so you have to support them, right? But we go and we went and you know got inspired, heard the songs, like Alut bands on Duragatta, because obviously like before that, it was like Backstreet Boys and Take That era, right? One day, I remember when we were in school, Suresh will, I don't know if he will deny this or not. He was practicing. This is early days. I don't think Stigmata was even Stigmata then. I think he probably had the idea in his head. Take That like a Back For Good riff practice karna, Suresh. Imagine. I don't think anyone knows this story. I think then Tenny came along and Andrew came along, and like, I mean, they're doing great things, and it's sad that they don't have the like the mainstream exposure, but maybe they kind of don't want that as well, right? They're that kind of band who, you know, we don't need to be like known all over, but I know they're like known elsewhere, like outside of Sri Lanka. So that's, I went to St. Thomas's, graduated in, so I didn't finish my A-levels. I did London A-levels, finished like the first AS levels, whatever. Then went for my higher education. I went to England. England gihilla, avahama passe. I was in like Sri Lanka for 2 years, whatever. And I moved to Canada in 2011. And that's like how the whole entrepreneur thing started. I have many sides to me, bro.
What's your earliest memories of music when you were like a kid?
So I barely remember this. I think my mom and dad used to say that issara labamba danna to mama nidhi karanda ba. So they used to they had this cassette. I think Manghitana, they played on and on. I think earliest memories of music after that is probably, my dad was a huge Sabbath and Zeppelin fan. So my dad passed away pretty early. So before he, you know, before we got to kind of, I was 8 when my dad passed away. So we didn't have that father-son like musical journey together, but he left a lot of cassettes and like records for me to kind of explore when I was older. So which was a nice thing, right? Mm. He was a huge Zeppelin fan, Sabbath fan, Ekali music ahapu porak. I think my musical journey or my earliest memory of music was Eva Valim Passe Manghidani, like Gypsies. I was a huge fan of Gypsies podikale. That's how like music I think that's how like the musical journey started or the inspiration started.
Maja, you said about Rock Saturday. Itakota, me and my brother, we used to come all the way from Nigamba for the Rock Saturday gigs.
Halavat is big doggy.
Big doggy is very near to me also. We went to the same. He come much and we don't have our Vaunia bus, we go back. We are early 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock.
You're talking like 96, 97, 98, Oekale?
Oh, 98 onwards again, it's a lot of concerts happening. Up to 2001, 2002. We went to all the gigs, Stigmata, launches, everything. We had like 4 or 5 of us. We always go to Colombo. We don't have money also. Money nahi machang, we just, you know, get money just for the ticket and bus ticket. We'll get the bus and go.
So I think like post or even like during Stigmata time, metal scene, Yanagamangma, there was another wave, this Krebs Cycle, Deja Vu. They started playing these pool. Pool was the thing, right? Like, so we go to these pool parlors to sneak in a cigarette or whatever. Kaurut balanne, machang, mata matakai, api uniform mandra gila cigarette bono, kaurut mukut kya ne na ekal. We had this place in Mount Lavinia. Gaul Road deke tibba, mukakar pool parlor. We go and nicely smoke up there in like after school in uniforms and all. After school, school level, very rarely that happens. But kaurut mukut kya ne masang ekal. I don't think they had like the, you know, a connect when, because I guess laws were more lenient back in the day, right?
I think we had a best period in Colombo, Sri Lanka, no, when we were growing up.
Yeah. And like though the war and stuff was going on back in the day, I think we were teenagers, right? We probably didn't feel that echaram danenda natu hati. I don't know, like looking back. I'd say people were happier probably, neither the technology there. We were like, we did things outside, right?
I think what I feel is, Majan, the because of the technology, things are getting exposed now. Things were probably there, but nobody was focused on. Everybody has time and technology thing, everything gets. So Kamach, tell me a little bit about your business, your journey in Canada. I know that you work for like music, movie production and stuff.
Yeah.
Can you tell me a little bit about
that? Yeah, Majan. So I work for this company called E1 Entertainment One. So they're like the biggest independent movie distributor in Canada and the US. So I worked for the US team basically, though we were in Canada. So US or Canada, they come across.
Right.
So I worked on films like Hunger Games, Expendables, Twilight, Twilight Post, post-release. I worked on it a little bit. So I worked on the marketing side. By the time that we got laid off, I was managing a team of 2 or 3 people. So I've worked on a bunch of movies. I've worked on a bunch of kids shows. That's what I studied, Mazam, basically after my... So I did my postgraduate studies in film and TV, marketing and distribution. So that's how I got into the whole film thing. Then I think I got laid off, started my own business, and now as you see, which is my passion, Mazang. So I'm very happy doing what I love doing.
Yeah. So you personally collect sneakers as well?
Yes, Mazang. So this is my personal collection.
Oh wow.
this is actually I've cut down on a lot of stuff. I had like close to 300 pairs, but then now I've somehow brought it down to like 150, 175 ish. There's still stuff outside that needs to come in here. But then like I made it like I don't buy as much as I used to buy. Now that I'm living that sneaker life 24/7, so I don't necessarily buy something unless like I really like it. It is sell anything, and like you go to work in another company. So there are probably pairs I've never worn. So you wear a new pair every day, so it's like an obsession, right? Because like, you know, I'm in the business, I know how stuff works, I know the cost of making sneakers, and sometimes when like a pair of sneakers is like $600-700, I'm like, it's just rubber, so why do you spend? Because I know the production costs, right? So I'm like, this is pointless. Because yeah, in Malaysia also ogolang industry must be like huge, the sneaker industry, right?
Philippines, there's a big sneaker community. I have a couple of friends who are big sneaker heads, actually.
Yeah,
I have probably a few friends who have a similar collection.
Yeah. People think you're crazy, but
so you started the subscription business, the sneaker tab. How did that convert it to a actual store, milk store?
So Mazang, so subscription is separate, milk is separate. So subscription is still on. So we treat it as two separate businesses, though it's under like the one major holding company. The two companies are under that. We wanted to. So there were a few brands that we couldn't get without a retail spot. So when you go to like the big dogs, like the Nikes and the Adidas's and like even New Balance, you go and say you're an online business, no matter how successful you are, no matter how much money you make, they want to know that it's a stable business. And like a lot of these salespeople, especially in Canada, are older. So they've been in the industry for like 30, 40 years, and they're like probably 50, 60 year old guys. So they're slowly converting into like e-commerce. Dangiting mayawelati me corona asse stores wahalane. But they are more reluctant to open e-commerce only stores. So we opened a few. You know, we had accounts with Puma. We had accounts with brands like Saucony. Evagi dekatunak tibba masang. But when you go for the big dogs, it helps to, you know, to seal the deal if you actually have a retail spot. So. Then I decided we need to have a retail spot, and then I was working. So for the first say 1.5 years, I was working out of my house, and I needed warehouse space as well. So so we opened up Milk we ship out of there, and we have a retail store there. It serves as a warehouse and as a retail store. So that's the main reason, because in this economic climate. Otherwise, I wouldn't have gone for a retail store. But it's ekat masang. I wanted to do it a little different rather than calling it foot something. I wanted to create like an experience. So that's why it's called Milk. I don't know if you probably haven't seen pictures. It's a milk and cereal themed store. So.
That's why I posted the cereal and milk earlier.
that's what it was, masang. Whatever I do, I want to do it a little different than other people. Ape Lankawe aye godak mata den oy milk kiyala damma comments ema dala thi baapo melo rahanne mokadda bang ube kade namai sapattu yala penne na, and I'm like, idiot, I'm thinking like, you know, far, far beyond what you're thinking. So because of that, I think we got a lot of good PR from like Toronto itself.
Right.
The city of Toronto gave us a plaque saying thank you for opening up like an experience store and all that. Called the city councillors, Lava Balanda. We got a lot of good press. In the first year, we were named the best new fashion store in Toronto. That's just because we decided to gamble and, you know, do something a little different.
Yeah, with the e-commerce thing, with Amazon and everything, if they're coming up, machang, the retail business, I mean, retail stores are actually getting, you know, going away, but not 100%. Neither. Whatever will remain, the premier type shops where you get a experience will remain, all the other things will go away, right?
Yeah, exactly. But whatever you're doing, like if you're doing a retail store, you can't just open a retail store. Like, you know, you can't put a bunch of shelves, put like shoes or clothes and open a retail store. It has to be an experience. It's like, I tell people all the time, like whatever business you're doing, it's like making a movie. It's basically storytelling, whatever you're doing. Like what you're doing right now is storytelling. It's storytelling. Even if it's a podcast, if it's a TV program, whatever business in life you do, whatever you decide to do, you have to convey that story to your customer. It's basically you telling a story to your customer. So without that like middle portion, like no matter how good the story is, how good the products you carry, it doesn't translate. It's at first it's like, okay, business, that's how we, like, you know, that's how normally you think, right? But that's not it. Like a business, I think a businessman and an entrepreneur are two different things. Entrepreneurs, most of the time, either they want to make a change or a difference in the world, or they like to do what they like and earn money and be happy.
Right.
That's my explanation of an entrepreneur.
Right. I agree with that. So one thing I saw when going through your profile and stuff is that you participated in the program, the Dragons Den, which is the original Shark Tank, right? That's original Shark Tank.
Correct.
Bajak, can you tell me a little bit about that? Going on Dragons Den?
Yeah, so I went on in 2017. Oh, then 3 years, the more. 3 years, oh. 2017. So they actually, when I first started Sneaker Top, they reached out to me first. Within a few months of opening, because abhi business ka patanga ta kama, we got some good press because nothing like this existed, right? So they were like, okay, this guy from Toronto is trying to do this thing, whatever. So they reached out to me and said, come on the show. I said no, because we weren't doing well. We weren't a proper company then. It was just me shipping shit out of my house, right? So I'm like, this is not a business yet. So I don't want to go and, you know, get embarrassed in front of like whole of Canada. Mm. So I'm like, let me stabilize this business a little bit more. And then I told the producer, like, I was honest. I said, we are not a proper business right now. But give me 1 year, I'll come back to you. And then in 2016, I think, 2016, by 2017, about March, I think they shot in May and broadcasted in November. But by about March, patangate auditions and all the stuff. So I applied. The business was doing well at that time. And I had an idea of what I was doing, because mulatike, you know, you're scrambling and you really don't know what you're doing, right? So I had figured out my business. I knew the numbers well, and I was comfortable about talking about my business, because by that time I've pitched like Puma and all these guys like hundreds of times to like get an account. So I knew the business inside out. So I reached out to them and said, So it goes through like a producer process. You go and pitch to the producers. It was the producers la choose karna honda da nadda kiyala. Then what they do is they put you in front of the dragons and they, you know, record the show. But ඔය record කරන එවලින් මගන් 100ක් විතර තමයි broadcast වෙන්නේ. But they shoot about 500, 600 episodes, like oh. individual things. But they choose the best for broadcast. I think it wasn't like, it was, I think, for me, that was probably the highlight of like my career, because that's probably the biggest stage or like the national TV spot that I've ever been on in Canada. And mata hema thing mama ewata nervous na masang, because like as long as you, for me, as long as I know my business, and but I did my research, and you know I did my homework before I went in there. Seasons 12ක් තිබ්බා, ඒ seasons 12ම 11ක් තිබ්බා. I watched all 11 seasons. I prepared for every kind of question. I watched Shark Tank, ekak baluwa, British Dragons den baluwa, okkom baluwa meda balanda thiyena okkom baluwa balla. That was my, you know, that was my study, and that's why you'll see me on the episode, I'm not like stressed out or I'm not sweating like baya vela na, and what you see is a 7-minute cut that pitch actually went on for an hour and a half,
right?
I knew my business inside out, so I wasn't nervous or anything. But you know, like before you walk down those steps, you have like butterflies in your tummy. But like, I think pretty much within like the first 5 minutes, like I was on. Joke at the gaddala danna. You know, curly hair, all the Sri Lankan charm, me gaddala katti wala gat.
But what they proposed was not really a big deal, did it?
So this is what happened, Maja. AK wede thiyenne. So whatever they propose on air is not the actual deal. And okay. Because I did my research, I knew that. So I always knew whatever deal I get on TV is the deal I need to, like, you know, I need to look good on TV to get the deal, because that's the PR portion. That is the portion that I'm going to cut and, you know, send people ads and all that stuff. Right. I think ඒක ගොඩක් ওই ඩීල් එක මම ආගියු කරලා කතා කරන්න ගිහින් ඉවර බැක් එන්ඩ් ඇන්ඩ් ඒගොල්ලෝ එඩිට් එකේ දැම්මේ මසන් ද රෝන්ග් ඩීල් බිකෝස් ද ඇක්චුවල් ඩීල් වී ගොට් වස් 100,000 ෆෝ 40% not 50,000 ෆෝ 40% එඩිට් කරන එක කොහොම හරි වරද්දලා 50,000 එකෙන් කට් කරලා ඒක බිකෝස් ඒකට ඩීල් එක හම්බෙන්නයි අරු ප්‍රපෝස් කරන තැනයි මැද වෙන කෑල්ලක් තියෙන සම්හව් දැට් හස් ගොට් කට් අවුට් සෝ දැට් වස් ඉන් ද ඔරිජිනල් ඩීල් ඊවන් 100,000 ෆෝ 40% වස් not and I we didn't need money මසන් when we went on. I went for PR and it's a prime time spot that for free. So that's why we went, to be honest with you. But if it was a good deal, we were going to do the deal. But so because I knew that, I'm like, mangoka goda kagiyu karanne yanne na, let's just look good on TV and I'll figure it out later with them. Because I know there's like a year of going back and forth before they close the deal. So I knew that, Kali. Anyway, it didn't work out because it wasn't the right deal for us or for them. Anyway, when people go on the show, only about 2% of the deals actually go through in real life.
Right.
Deals go down. They don't make a single link. You don't have to go down. Deals go down. They don't have to see it. They don't have to see deals. They don't have to see it. They don't have to see it. And it worked out well for everyone because we didn't need money at that time. Oh. And we got enough exposure to, you know, stabilize the business for the next 2-3 years. Wage ehema ekak una, but it's not exposure. Can Shark Tank ge exposure ka nam Lankawa people found out who I was through this clip that went viral, million mokadda gana giya me on Facebook. So people in Sri Lanka kind of found out who I was and what I was doing and all that. Ekak tara only you know, it's not like mass nekak nemei, it's very, you know, a selected audience, people who are, you know, interested in marketing, entrepreneurship and all that.
Your clip went on that array. There's this Facebook page called Eliphas.
Yes.
Okay, all the Sri Lankan they feature all the Sri Lankans, no?
yeah eka thamai wede giye.
I also saw that you actually spoke on a conference which had also Richard Branson on that.
Oh, Mazang. So we did that. But Eka, they announced the bill, but it didn't go through, Mazang, because due to some mokakkari organizers lage me meka case ekak welama san the conference satiyakata issala apita eka cancel kara but that would have been a great opportunity but I'm on the bill with him so I don't care it would have been again but it's also like this right like Richard Branson katha karala ida passe um mata katha karanna de na Richard oh. Branson would have spoken on a different stage and I would have been on the smaller stage right
oh.
or it's the same stage man that because I can't remember exactly what the setup was because it was so far back I think Richard Branson session was one day ida passe tamai api hitiye like the new entrepreneurs kind of thing and Richard Branson is like the keynote speaker he'll do his thing like mm. උදේ පාන්දර කරලා අපි අර එච්චර හරිනේ සෙට් එක හවසට දානවා වගේ තමයි කියන අලුත් සෙට් එක හවසට දානවා වගේ සීන් එකක් තිබ්බේ බට් ඉතින් රිචඩ් බ්‍රැන්සන් එක බිල්බෝඩ් එකේ ඉන්න එක මට ඇතිම සර් දැට්ස් ගුඩ් ඉනෆ් ෆෝ මී I think other than probably other than චමත් පලිහ පිටිය චමත් පලිහ පිටිය is you know චමත් පලිහ පිටිය of Facebook right,
right?
ඉතින් ඒ වගේ like ඉන්නවම සංස් there's a lot of there are a lot of Sri Lankans who are doing stuff but මේමයි අපේ audiences වලට ඒවා හොයලා මේ මේවා කරන්න පසන් අනේ මන්ද ඕනේ නැහැ එහෙම they are our mass audience is stuck in you know gossip and bullshit I don't know මං ඉතින් ඒකයි මේ podcast කර කර මේ රෑ නිදි මරාගෙන මුන්ට podcast කරන්න මස ඔළුව හදන්න because එහෙම හොඳ මාර මේ intelligent mature audience ekak innawa masan but no one's doing content for them
yeah,
so yeah. it could be 2000 people it could be 5000 people like podcast downloads the 2000 but that's the core audience who really want to consume your stuff
anith ekama chat the Sri Lankan the mentality the mindset has to be changed metana they always majang you go to university you get a job you get a car you get a house you get married then you die eka thamai yeah. life there's nothing else you mm-hmm. never chase your passions you never you know work on your hobbies ari monari yeah. you never go chase that I really hated that when I was like growing up I gave up in A level itself I said no I'm not going to university I'm going to study IT again I wanted to do something ega keruwa machin then I moved out of the country
mm.
I came here like for 1 month assignment that yeah. was like 14 years ago
and you ended up staying
then ended up staying mokada there was always when I was growing up in Sri Lanka there was this empty there was something missing I mm. for me especially like a person I like you know like metal and rock and everything machin there's always something missing ඉතින්
ඔය ඔයාලට හරියට කන්සර්ට් එකක් බලන්න නෑ ඔය ප්‍රශ්න කොට දෙපා අපිත් ලංකාවෙත් දෙම බ්‍රයන් ඇඩම්ස් එනවා මතන් අර මේ බක් මහට ගාන එන වගේ වෙන කාලයකට සැරයක් කවුරු හරි එකෙක් එනවා ඒකත් you have no choice right like once you move out here like I'm not like you know Sri Lanka is a much smaller country and you know we are a developing country so we don't have the infrastructure that these guys have
right
but we could have had the infrastructure because we could have built it since 1948 right
like, right
karanda puluwan masan but it's like mehemai the economic power it, you know it, this podcast can go on for like 4 hours if we start talking about this political bullshit but I don't want to go there but I think yeah once you get the taste of like outside like I love going back to Sri Lanka man. I try to go back like once a year last year I went back 4 times මේහිටියට වැඩිය ගිය අවුරුද්ද ලංකාවේ දුන්නේ. I spent about 4 months there on and off yeah like during 4 different times. Obviously I love Sri Lanka and I love my people. I love the passion they have but අපේ උන්ට පොඩි බූස්ට් එකක් දෙන්න ඕනේ මචං. මොකද මේ ඒක දෙන්නේ නැතුව මේ creative thinking කියන එක අපිට දීලා නැහැ because we were always told to follow
Oh.
You do this. Structure can go. I mean, sir, joke ek kuti par paar hai hua. Kya na go. Me, kya kisi ma me creatively, matlab innovate penda. Me. We are not taught to be innovators. Like mostly. There are guys like who are outside of this equation obviously e unata matan man hitanne majority e prashne thama thiyeno e prashna nam thiyena mokada mata godak therena matan mata minissu magen ahana kene kollo kello taruna aya ahana prashna walin ehema mata therena ayya business ekak patan gannona mata salli hoyanna mata idea ekak denna and I'm like that's not the question you should be asking asking, right? Like, Mama Hambelam, can follow your passion. Mm. Find out if there's a way to, you know, make money from it. How you find out is, you have to, and you have to do your basic research. Samaharlaṭa mata mage comment ekking prashnayak kahale berala u mama oka dakala reply karanna dawas 3kin reply karanna uttare ena tikata uta Google kala vinadi 2kin meka hoya ganna puluwa.
Oh.
And people don't think like that, right? Like, I'm not saying anything because that's the way we are trained. School e textbook ekak balagena kiyana issara ape sala textbook ekak kiyawala mata apita liya ganna kiyanne textbook ekak kochchara gonda like again, education system make a venas vendor. That is, see, I if I go into this, this is going to be like going down the rabbit hole. But I think basically creatively cool. Then aluteng we have exposure to the world, maga YouTube peno, araka peno, meka peno, abita eka karanda puluwang definitely. Gamwala kollanta dan data tiyena. I think kiyanda tiyenne gossip gong ewa balabal innatu mokak hari oluwata wedagath deyak balanda kiyala, because there's two ways of doing it, right? You can watch all the shit on YouTube. Oh. And you can also, people have no excuse. People have no excuse. People have no excuse. We have all the resources in the world available.
Yeah, imagine. So you tapped into YouTube. Can you tell me a little bit about when you really discovered YouTube and what was your earliest start on YouTube?
I did a bunch of stuff for like my company stuff. Like, I discovered, like, you know, content creation is possible. But I was also like, on YouTube. Right. Like, I'm an entrepreneur. So I could go down the business route, or I could do I could do other stuff. Entertainment ekak mona hari me karanda me podda hita mona dorawa denna ape wife kada kaya gahana ballata oda sorry the baga can be really clingy uda bind one etoda thama nida gan me kapapan me kala so machang yeah so that's what happened mama I couldn't figure out what I needed to do at first. So I was like, do I do the entertainer thing, like, you know, do like a chat show or whatever, or should I do the entrepreneur thing? You think, mulimma channel ekak patan gatha oy dekama ticket ek kara. But it wasn't like no one was watching and all that. Then I had a film background anyway, right? So I wanted to like, mazang, it was like, okay, I'll decide on one. I'll start with the entertainment thing, and if this takes off, maybe I'll start a second channel and do the whole entrepreneur thing.
Right.
So what I did was oy channel ekak patan gatta mata palawini video ekata 3000 views whatever and it took off tika take off vela ithin mama lankawa thamai I shoot everything in Sri Lanka. What I do is magan I go dawas 10 ekata vithara gihilla iwarala episode 20 30ak shoot karagena enawa evilla I periodically I release them.
All right.
So that's why I started the second channel, because second channel is more about content, not about like, you know, visual quality and all that. So it goes hand in hand with the podcast. So usually when I bring a guest, I do like what you do. Unge moonat dala matang eka podcast ekata dala eka YouTube ekata dala. But when I'm like actually doing the podcast, I upload the audio version only. YouTube is a good way, matang, if, you know, for even for businesses and, you know, entrepreneurs and all that, you can get a good reach if you do the right thing on YouTube. Like, you will, you can wrong ekakarat gossipu yo kunu godawal tik okkoma karat madan you will get views. But how satisfied are you at the end of the day anith minissunge kunu vigunla ivara vela views aragena kiyana eka thamai mama kiyanne. Ekay ape dan Lankawa vela tiyena masan eka we latch on to whatever is popular ne.
No,
ehema ekak tiyenawane. Then metal කාලයක් metal popular වුණාම rock popular වුණාම ඔක්කොම උන් rock සින්දු කියන්න ගන්නවා. ඒ කියන්නේ අර daddy ලගේ I don't know how much you know about single Sri Lankan single music is, but daddy ලගේ massina popular වුණාම උන් අර මල්මල් shirt ඇඳගෙන 70s විතර කරාම ඔක්කොම උන් ටික ඒ වගේ කරනවා. ඊට පස්සේ 2009 හරි 2010 හරි rambari popular වුණාම 4-4 සින්දුක ගහිටපු ඔක්කොම උන් 6-8 ගහන්න බෑ. ඔව්. එහෙම තමයි. ඊට පස්සේ මල් සින්දු කියලා මල් සින්දු සෙට් එක පටන් ගත්තා. ඔක්කොම උන් දැන් මල් සින්දු කියනවා. අර ඒ වගේම so we like to follow right වෙනස් දෙයක් කර. දැන් හිප් හොප් popular වුණා. ඉතින් මේ ඒක එතකොටත් ගොඩක් හිප් කියන්නේ සාමාන්‍යයෙන් හිප් හොප් කියන්නේ ඒක රයිම් ස්කීම් එකක් දාන්න නැති බාස් ගාන දාන්න නැති. එහෙම කිසිම කියන්නේ no research okay. අලුතෙන් කරන්න එපා කියනවා නෙමෙයි මම but do some research and you know like get the basics right before you do something අර එහෙම පොඩි රැල්ලට යන සීන් එකක් තියෙනවා අපි ඉතින් දැන් මේ දවස්වල රැල්ල තමයි YouTube මත ඉතින් ඔක්කොම කියන්නේ මොකක් හරි talk with එකක් ගන්නවා මේකක් ගේනවා මම just stand එකක් ගහලා කතා කරනවා I'm not I have nothing personal against these people but I'm saying එහෙම එකක් කරත් ඒකේ පොඩි මොකක් හරි twist එකක් දාලා ඉවල මොනවා හරි පොඩි අමුතු දෙයක් කරන්න because there are so many talk withs මචං it's like doing my head in like what the hell are these people doing like it and it's also the same people that arakin eka meket innō mekin eka araket innō hama ekema ranjan
maja I really so
like I actually wanted to bring ranjan on my show because mage eka wenas nema not to talk about his you know backsides and all that mata me I wanted to talk to him about me then where he ray gilla because I wanted to bring him on the podcast so if anyone's watching and who has a contact me mokada api call karahama there his press person didn't know what a podcast was me YouTube ekata enne na kiyala kiyuwa mokak hari hari okay no problem kiyala wala mama kiyuwa probably had no idea who was calling or whatever man me mama danna ne ba minissu I just wanted to talk to him about maja ekena oya ekena e oya characters wala thiyena maja vena pathi you can you know dive into so after the whole you know backside okay thing whatever meva leak una passe mu kohomada maja mental state ekak hondata thiyagena like that's what I wanted to talk about. I wanted to dig deep into like how he you know how he creep back into culture and now it's like nothing happened
right
like he's a good marketer definitely so I wanted to talk about that side so iraj wage kawa hari genawat masan like I'm not talking about his politics or kunu or whatever I want to talk about how he's a great marketer like
no
whatever he does iraj is a great marketer right like I met the guy once he's a very like I don't know he doesn't look like an aggressive guy or he doesn't look like the guy who stirs up the pot and you know meva එහෙම එහෙ plant කරන but it's how the mind works right so right. He's a great marketer like kudos to him for that me e wage ekak tama mata katha karanna ona
machan the one of my favorite episodes what you did with Shiraz and then with Filthy the yes. Bass at the bass eka first time I really watched this Filthy actually rapping you know like in English machan that was really crazy
ah machan hadala kiyana ewa that's right so a lot of people said why are you know giving Filthy a platform this guy like you know sings filthy songs and all that but that's not what I focused on right I focused on he's one of the only like few rappers in Sri Lanka who can actually freestyle off the top
right
so that is what I'm focusing on I didn't ask about his you know girlfriends and all of the media so he's actually a nice guy he's a nice guy in real life api wage machan normal porakku ඉතින් මම ඒව ફોકસ කරේ නෑනේ මම කියන්නේ whoever I bring on the show even if I bring you know මොකෙක් කරේ හොරෙක් ගෙනාවත් but I focus on what I want to focus on right like I'm the guy who drives the conversation not him so අර conversation එක එහෙ මෙහෙ යන්නේ when the guy cannot drive the conversation when the interviewer or whoever cannot drive the conversation ඒකයි you can focus on different things you know negative ඒව තියෙන මිනිස්සුන්ගේ positives ගැන focus කරන්න පුළුවන් and that's the skill that I focused on with Filthy and Shiraz of course is like one of the pioneers man a legend ne and he's is such a you know down to earth guy band e wage ekak damata masan views enne kiyada 3000 ay anamma na
no
okak hari kawuru hari ekege kunu godak damma nan enowa 100000 Filthy but I don't want to be like that like it's that's pointless I'm talking against that and I don't want to keep doing that and Shiraz is such a great guy and he's like so humble right kohoma indone kochchara oluwen indone man because he's a legend like a lot of these kids don't know who Shiraz is
I was amazed machang that he actually went to Jamaica learned the language and he's actually singing in Jamaican I thought he's like you know he's just saying random stuff but it's not right it's really
no, that's you're Jamaican that's commitment bro like you move to Jamaica and you learn patwa like it's crazy ඇලූ කියන ඒවා තේරෙන්නේ නැහැ බං මං ඌට ටෙක්ස් කරන්න කැමති නැහැ ඌ පට්වා වලින් මට රිප්ලයි කරනවා so I don't know what the hell is saying so I'm like I told I said it to him as well why interview එකත් මං කියලා like yes bro no bro වග්වාන් ගගා ගානෝ මම දන්නේ නැහැ අර ඉස්සර මගේ කොණ්ඩේ කපන එකක් ජමේකන් and he speaks in පට්වා මං ඌට කියන්නේ එකක් ඌ කරන්න එකක් ඌ කියන එක මට තේරෙන්නේ නැහැ මං කරේ කොට තේරෙන්නේ
Much at going into podcasts, the reason I like podcasts because we do longer conversations. Etakota, yeah. You can talk about a lot of things, different sides of the conversation. You can pick the brain of the other person, and those ideas you can absorb, and you can do something with that later on. So
definitely.
Any of the podcasts that you listen to, what are the favorite podcasts that you listen to normally? Outside of
Bajang, on a weekly basis, I listen to a podcast called Crime Junkies.
All right.
So it's Bajang, a true crime podcast. Again, solve true crime cases. I think Bajang, I think it's like the number two podcast, like on the podcast charts on Spotify. I listen to a lot of Gary Vee. Bajang, Gary Vee is an entrepreneur. Gary Vee ge bang daily udana one magula kahano hamadama han. I listen to Joe Budden podcast. Then Tava Kahano Machang Jay Shetty podcast.
Jay Shetty is very inspirational, right?
Yeah, yeah. Oya Hattara Tamai, like I rotate usually, but like Crime Junkie and Gary Vee are probably like the top two on my list. Lankavi Illumination kila podcast ka te, no? I think they're pretty much the biggest. I was on the podcast about a week ago, so mangiya dawasina ng ekahano.
That's yeah.
Gary Vee, your podcast is available in audio form too, right?
Yeah. Okkoma thiyenawa. It's in Spotify, Apple, Google, and okkoma.
Oage tadina. But your stuff I watch on like YouTube or Facebook. Facebook number danne godak.
Oh. I read the book of Gary Vee actually. Gary Vee
Jab Right Hook.
The yellow book ekak mokadda macha?
Jab Jab Right Hook man hitana hatiya. I don't read books macha. I listen to audio books.
Oh,
so I don't know
the I discovered Gary Vee. It was supported because he became a millionaire doing wine, right? His father's business.
Yeah. His father's business. He's basically a 3 billion business. Man hitana 30 million, 300 million. Ohena loku ganakata he scaled it. Like back in the day, like using email marketing and stuff.
So you have, what are the shows you have? Bars at the Bar, and then Daiya Show, what else?
Daiya Show, tera madam, Bars at the Bar, tera tawa api nodanna business kiya laga, tera on the main channel. Tawa Bed and Breakfast kiya laga shoot kala, tera. I haven't put out any episodes of that yet. It's like, oya hatara tamai, because Daiya Show is on hiatus right now. Season 2 is shot and ready to go. හැම එකටම පොඩි දෙන්න එපා මසම් බ්‍රේක් එකක්. Daiya Show episodes කොහෙ 20කට ලඟ වෙන්න ඇවිල්ලා තියෙනවනේ. Close to I don't think 20 or close to about at least 15 16 episodes. So I'll give it a little break and like start back in like September. වගේ Daiya Show. මේ දවස්වල හැබැයි අතර මේන් channel එකට focus වෙන්නත් මේ podcast කර second channel එකට තමයි because podcast is so like it's like if I think something much I record and I put it out. Like and it's so quick, right? Again it ටක්ගල ඔක ඇන්කයකෙන් දාපු ගමන් යනවනේ මචං ස්ටෝස් වලට දෙකෙන් තුනෙන් තියනවනේ බඩු මේ ඒකින්ද මම and it's much easier right like I have a mic here I just like plug it in and I just like record my thoughts and edit කරන්න මුකුත් නැහැ මචං I just intro music එකයි යනම නැහැ ඒ ටික දානවා but ඒක it's I think it's a for me it's probably my favorite way of like favorite form of content මං හිතන්නේ podcast
I started mostly, I got into podcast much, I'm listening to Joe Rogan. Joe Rogan podcast. Joe Rogan Experience.
Joe Rogan Experience, I'm on YouTube.
Oh,
but I don't
YouTube.
Like listen to it in like podcast form.
He only had it in Apple. No, he doesn't have it in Spotify, but he made a 100
Spotify
million.
Deal,
right? They're saying it will be like 100 million, 100 million deal, right?
Pissuakka.
Your happy hour, you did a happy hour episode with Dhananjay, Dhananjay Abhivardhan.
Dilshan. Yeah.
ඒකෙන් පස්සේ I started watching his vlog. ඒක මේ addictive.
Oh, maru masan. He's a maru atheist. හරිද? And ඔකගේ තියෙනවා ඌ කතා කරද්දි මතක් මාර يعني he's so interesting. يعني දවස් ගණන් කතා කර කර ඉන්න පුළුවන් ඉඳගෙන ඌත් එක. And that's why I want to bring it. And he has a lot of haters too because අපේ අර traditional frame එකෙන් පොඩ්ඩක් එලියට ගියාම ඌ atheist කියලා වෙලම ඌ يعني පොඩ්ඩක් අපේ මේ 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 මේවා ඔඩියන්සර්ස් වලට ගැලපෙන්නේ නැති දේවල් කියනවා and being and you know being on social media and being on these platforms you have to be really careful ne sometimes you cannot always speak your mind
no
pita kiyanna one හැම එකම කියන්නේ නැහැ අපි අලුවොත් එක්ක කියන ඒවා මචන් කියන්නේ නැහැ ne මේවල sometimes you know we say controversial things no you be everyone right
no
ඒකනේ ඒක රංජටුනේ that's what happened ekinda you have to be really careful but that is his brand and he doesn't care about haters and that's what he wants to do he's like I'm speaking my mind eka thama man karanne ide e athi mara brave and he's a super nice guy and entrepreneur content creator weda godak karanna porak
eka majan like he's just like eating buying a chicken bun and eating the chicken bun but it's really interesting mama me
yeah.
every time mara new episode deck ekenoda I watch
maru ar podi ka vinadi 5ක් විතර ඇතුළ තුගේ අර වැඩේ ඔක්කොම දවසම අපිට බලන්න ඕන I don't have time otherwise I would have done something like similar but මේ දවස් වලට ඉතින් මුකුත් action නැහැ and then ඉඳන් පල්ලෙහාට එනවා ඔෆිස් එකට මෙතන වැඩ කරුවා I would have done පල්ලොත් එක්ක සෙල්ලම් කරනවා ඕව දවසම බලන්න බැහැ and I have two kids maja so it's like they take up a little bit of my wife does most of the work I don't mang etra dawasata I can if she does 90% I do 5% but ema thamai wede yanne
macha let's talk about little bit about your music so yeah. I know you had a song mokada wanghung that yeah. was the first song ne the
oh eka thamai macha first eka and that's probably the biggest the most I've penetrated the market I'd say and it was a quality production Ayesh Vijayaratna matak karanna one matha he was like one of the pioneers in Sri Lanka and you know he was if he was still alive today he passed away sadly a few years ago umara ekena venas vidiyata hitana manusyek wada so like with the budget I gave him ekali 300,000 laksha 3 budget ekata matha umata දැන් අවුරුදු 10ක් වංගුන් එකට අදටත් සුද්දොට්ට පෙන්නුවම උන් කොර වෙනවා like for the way it's been it's shot and it hasn't aged for 10 years man the video hasn't aged and ඒ කාලේ අවුරුදු 10කට ඉස්සෙල්ලා උ 1080p ද හොම් මට ඕවා කියන මට ඕවා තේරෙන්නේ නැහැ ඒ කාලේ 1080p shoot කරලා and Kalinga Deshapriya is the guy is the was the director of photography he's here actually now උත් එකම වැඩ කරනවා කියන්නේ I meet him and all that and so that was like my like entry into like the music industry but like man it pass then apita tiyana prashne okane man lankawae komata revenue hoyanda bae ne unless you perform live ithin api karana oy alternative rock uy anamana walata man me stage show walin apita enda kiyanne ne owa kiyanda ithin that's why I moved out of Sri Lanka as well because I really wanted to do the music thing full time but you know things happened and you have to grow up at a certain point but now I think I'm comfortable in life where I can like try out music again but like I think my sound has changed now because I've started producing myself me mokada mata matan den ape daddy eke chikata sindu addila produce karanne den avurudu 10ak man avadama kiyana uda ba avurudu 10ak gatta dummy ekak pat tam mata dala dudde naha kiyala so it's because everyone's busy right and they're performing as well like daddy is a huge band and they're performing I think like unta matam venaka even we are, if we are friends venaka ge hari sinduwak produce karanna tarang indagena karanna welawak enne na matam which is like reasonable
right
so I'm like meka hariyanne na I'm all about DIY matam gedara weda ekena gedara weda arinda gedara weda karanna kemathi mena but you know if something's not working out like I'll look for a solution so I'm like okay like corona ava karanna deyanne mokadda man karanne ట్యూటోరియల్స్ వల్ లెవెల్ ఎఫ్ఎల్ స్టూడియో ఈ డాల్స్ టికక్ ఇగన గత్తమ అండ్ ఇతిన్ దెన్ ఓ కీబోర్డ్ ఎకిన్ ఓ మోనో మోనో హరి ఎకక్ గహల సాంపల్యక్ ఓహెన్ హరి అరగెన ఆ మట మొకక్ హరి ఎకక్ కరగన్న పులో అండ్ ఐ థింక్ సో ఐవ్ మేడ్ ఎ ఫ్యూ సాంగ్స్ విచ్ ఐ పుట్ అవుట్ వన్ ఇట్స్ ఆన్ జస్ట్ అవుట్ ఆన్ స్పాటిఫై ఐ డిడ్ ప్రమోట్ ఇట్ బికాజ్ ఏకే అనిమేటెడ్ వీడియో యాక్ కర్నో మత స్పాటిఫై గడ యూజువల్లీ టేక్స్ అబౌట్ 2 వీక్స్ టు లోడ్ මම කෝකටත් කියලා කලින් upload කරලා තිබ්බ මේ මගුල දවසින් load වෙලා. ඉතින් now it's on there so I'm like okay let it be. I'm not going to promote it. I think the sound has changed. It's I wouldn't say it's hip hop. අමුතුයි මට. මම දන්නේ නැහැ මේ you know අහනේ උන් කියන්නේ හොඳයි අමුතුයි කියලා. And I use like you know then the A song එකෙත් මම I use the kora like මේ මේ African instrument එකක් තියෙන kora කියලා ඉවරල ලොකු එක.
අනේ
ඒකේ sample එකක් පාවිච්චි කරේ. අර එහෙම so I try to you know I don't purposely try to sound different but අනිත් එක මම හදන වෙලාවට මම හදන්නේ සින්දුවත් එක්කම හදාගෙන produce කරගෙන යන්නේ. So I lay down a beat මසන් මම sample එක ගන්නවා. ඉතින් මෙතන ඉඳගෙන ඉවරලා ඒ වෙලාවෙම record يعني dummy එක ඒ වෙලාවෙම record කරනවා. So I don't you know beat එක හදලා පස්සේ ඉඳගෙන ලියන්නේ නැහැ. And I've been writing my own stuff. I've never done that before. Like because even Mang Hung like you know Manranga wrote it, Randika's melody, Daddy and you know Gaya Anchika, Lairo all of them produced it. It's I've been always working with other people. So I've been singing basically other people's songs all my life. And I haven't realized if I have a sound or a voice of my own when it comes to music, but I think now I'm slowly discovering it. But I think there is a podi signature sound ekak wage ekak hadigena yanawa and lyrics uth mamamai liyanne podi and it's and the themes that always come out for some reason podi social issues gana ekak enna dan oy aluth sinduwa dan mam oy release kara Spotify ekek thiyena kiyala so I named it Tanamalvila Kollek just to you know ara thiyenne famous mekak mata not in this like bolanda vidiyata me but in a you know ehema amuthu podi team ekak yanne and mu gamen kolamata gihilla e wage kathandara podi podi social line ekkut enawa and I'm doing a song with Costa and Mihindu I'm doing a song with drill team I'm doing a song with thawa kawuda big doggy yat ekek ekak tiyena hip hop karatte kiyala ekak tiyena big doggy ekka mama I wanted him on it it's he's featuring on it but manko album ekata uta daaganna kiyala wala eka his album is coming manko obaga gani album ekata kiyala wala me ara kk verse ekak yawana kall innawa eka
I also like that what you did that tribute video you did for the frontliners neida
oh mata eka mage project ekak neme actually me ape oy trimala namal kiyala wala mallila dennek innawa lankawae the trimala is a producer music producer and amal uge brother amal mallida ma okkoma coordinate karanna yanam mana So they sent me the track and said they want me on it. I think ara wedagath deyak hinda man think kara eka. Eka hondai. I like the it's the melody eka lassana. Ite ewa o duwan naha man 7000 8000 views. The mal sinduwa kala takkara takkara ekak gala gama nan ada. Gilla.
You were explaining that that is the mass market situation in Sri Lanka, ne?
minissunta baninnat baha masa because if that's what they want to listen to that's fine like let them listen I who am I to judge like music kiyanna bæna unta ithin ekena ewa hana minissunta masan e artist la freddy mercury la wage ahena wathi ithin unta freddy mercury wage ahenna ne apita ahena widiyata
Right.
Tamai, it's like your influence. It's what you listen to all your life. And some people who influence ekak meddedi break wenawa mathan honda music ekak api what we deem good music ewa handa patan aragena ara cycle ekak break wenawa. But at the end of the day mathan we are all going to die at some point. me wage podi ewa allagena apita kaya gahala kisi theruma
nathak naha.
Wedanne. And eken mathan industry ekak survive wenawa. Like all those like malgayeko kiyana set ekak and they are living off very well and that's what an industry should be right then api karana music ekak athule mathan me industry wala salli adui sanukalaata salli eken sanukalaata salli hambena like unless you are like mainstream and all that podi un set ekak salli naha ne patha again podium set and music well in salli ne.
Oh,
you pay money and you produce music, but there is no return, right? ඉතින් අර ඔක්කොමනේ සල්ලි තියෙනවා. ඉතින් ඔක්කොම උන් එක්කවෙලා මල් සින්දු කිව්වත් කමන්නේ නැහැ මචං. උන් හොඳට කාලා බීලා ඉන්නවනේ. From a business and a socio-economic standpoint, I think it's fine. Who are we to judge?
So, Machang, I want to get your reaction. I have some albums here.
Ah.
I'll show you.
Marziri, Billa sir, one of my favorite movies, Machang. One of my favorite people in the world, Budiyaya. I know him very well. Budiyaya was the end of the podcast. Sangeeta ke bada pe inoane mege. And this video is an iconic video, Mazang. Sindhu and the Wind Jayastri. And the soundtrack is like amazing. Okay, there are Salli Pokuru ekat okay.
Oh, mege dina Salli Pokuru itapaste Princey.
Princey.
ඔව් මේක ඇනිත් එක මෙයා කරානේ මේ මූවි එකේ තියෙනවා නේද මේ බොබ් මාලිගේ නෝ වුමන් නෝ කෝලේගේ සිංගල් වර්ෂන්
I remember when we used to say in a government yard in Maravilla අරමක ආදලෙක
යා බූඩි වචන් අයි few long time ago maybe 8-7 years ago මම try කරා මේ මිල්ලස් ඔයා මේ ස්ක්‍රීනින් එකක් කරන්න මේ for the Sri Lankan community.
Yeah.
I talked to Bodhi, but somehow it didn't happen. Maybe I should try again.
yeah. Maru movie. I've watched it like probably more than like 20 times.
Yeah, then I have Meka Machang, I have this one. Modgovia.
Modgovia Jayastri. Pioneers, right? Okay, Machang, Jayastri. I first heard Jayastri on Yes FM when they were called Condom.
Condom,
unge sindu at the put your love together da na da da na na wage ekak tibba ඊට පස්සේ අරක උඩ පළ ගත්තත් වට්ටක් අය you are my sunshine ඒ දෙක මම yes fm එකේ ඇහුවා and I'm like you are my sunshine උඩ පළ ගත්තා and it's like mind blown right මචං at that point so one of my I don't have it in ඔය format එකේ නෑ cd format එක ඔබ cd සානත්ත
I have machang here about 1500 CDs in my collection now.
Pissuak madam I buy records madam LPs thiyena my gaba owa ne anything LP format ekek ne ne
oh meva machang I have most of the original me Jayashree etakota Alien Accent Independent Square Stigmata
Alien Accent was kawda me ape Dylan Joseph fame hitiya neida
Alien
Accent machang those were like original music ekena oya kale machang TNL Yes FM but ape kale ne uba ekena danne me they promoted original English music then I think Yasmin Yusuf is doing a good job on Yes FM she does it I think and Alien Accent, they did an album as well, right? Album, my album.
I have that. You have it? Oh. Mama Machang, I was saying that Kaurwari dammod, Bhatiya Santosh dammod, Krishan dammod, Iraj dammod, I buy it. Mama Machang, I was always like that.
Independent Square, you know?
Oh, Independent Square, you know, make album.
One of my favorite Anil Machang mage favorite issara school yana kala ena my favorite is Anil api wabe Anil on stage jalin kapuwa mata tham matakai Anil la demo we had a band called Hangover Machang mamai Bertie I can't remember who else Michael Raj is Michael Raj paid for another band mokada u apita kiyanne nathuwa vena band ekkata gahala e kale harida apita me on stage then demo ek yawala uta ape band ekata enna kiyaddi arunwa select kala Sweet dreams are made of these. Marilyn Manson version, but we did like an acoustic version. Ekat ama demo ekata hari. And I think my voice, it sounded very close to Anil's voice.
Alright.
I have him on Facebook. I still talk to him. He was one of the guys like Independence Square was one of my favorite bands.
Yeah, Anil Machang, I know long time. Mama me whenever I go to Colombo before, Mama TN, like I just walk in. I ask him to, I want to talk about something, music, Unahari, can you play this song?
Anil used to date Masang, api school and kaal, Anil, I don't know who he's dating. Sorry, Anil, if I'm, letting the cat out of the bag, I have to do it. Anil used to date this chick, this girl, political. Anil used to date this girl, Masang. Mage ekale girlfriend ke yaluwek. But this girl was really pretty, Masang. I think api hulana issara. Anil was older. Ekale apita wediya tikak. Anil kolla wage hidiya tikak older Anil. අපි කියලා අපි කොල්ලෝ කියනවා මේ නාකියට කොහොමද මචං මේ වගේ එකක් සෙට් වුනේ කියලා අපි කියනවා අනිට good times.
ඔව් මේ මචං this one
මේ කවුද ප්‍රියසුරි සෙනේද? Yes, so my one of my මගේ wife ආසම එක්කෙනෙක් ආදරණීය නේරංජනායකට මගේ wife ආස. ඉතින් අපි සින්දු කියන හැම වෙලාවෙම එක් කියන්න වෙනවා. legendary, definitely legendary මචං. And unique voices, unique tones, like unique. I think Mihinduari Ratna, I don't know if you know anything about Mihinduari Ratna, Nemesis Kela Band.
I saw your episode, Mama Eka Bellua.
Mihindu is my neighbor, he's here. While I'm talking to you, because he lives next door.
Oh.
So he studied music, because I showed him around and all when he came here first. I didn't know, friends of friends, right? He has a very unique voice. Chitral's voice is very unique. I think Lahiru Perra is pretty unique as well. And Priya is probably one of the most unique voices. Tone nekai e variations. Mr. Priya ki ando nikam Priya ki ando hondane.
This one, last one.
Like CT Fernando. CT Fernando, personally, mama godak ahana. Artist kenek neme, but mata godak ehena artist kenek. He back in the day he did with the Western influence and all. I think he changed the. I think him eva tiyanone mata people who changed the course of music. I think CT Fernando is one of them. Ida passe magita Amaradeva master la CT la ta kaling ne. Victor Ratnayake egollo CT Fernando and I think Victor Ratnayake after that. ඊට පස්සේ මට මතක කාලේ මං කියන්නේ ජිප්සීස් change the game for මෙහෙම යන එක මෙහෙම කරන අය මත හරවන්නේ ඒ වගේ.
Sunflower
change the cassette game whatever, but mainstream වලින් මම දකින්න හතර පහ මං කියන්නම්කොට. ජිප්සීස් 1, රූකාන්ත in the 90s, රූකාන්ත ගුණතිලක. ඊට පස්සේ මට මතක හැටියට ඩැඩි. I don't know. Clarence before Rukanta. Clarence before Rukanta for sure. Clarence Gypsies, Rukanta. Mata ita passe oye gap peka. Atule Namal Ludugumat tinno masa. Namal Ludugum is there oye gap peka atule. But I don't know how much he changed the game. But Daddy changed the game for our generation. Daddy ita passe Rambari again Lahiru changed the game. Ita passe. I would say Vayo up to a certain extent, but apikauru dekeng, but it's like hema mahaluku venasak saddayak neme ne eka melody ka lassana Vayo. I would put in Vayo to the equation, and most recently I think Costa.
Costa has a lot of haters. Costa is really changing the game ne.
Oh man, Costa has a lot of haters. But all of these people had a lot of haters. Gypsies, Clarence, Daddy ita hitiya haters la adui mang hitanne. Anita ita wediya, but Rukanta Lahiru ta masang, he's a very close friend of mine. So Rambari ena kale, when Lahiru Perera wasn't like the Lahiru Perera, that we know, that you guys know, Lahiru was Lahiru Nilnuwan Perera. Lahiru Nilnuwan Perera kiyala thamai mama mu mulu namama danawa issara. Ithin mam man hitana mage buta kiyanne nathi mokada ehema munta kiyanne naha nathi mokada bam me godey weta Nilnuwan kiyala daagena lapa Lahiru Perera kiyala daagathuna hondai kiyala man hitin hitanawa muta. But then he, you know, he changed the game, appearance ekak wenas karala okkoma karala, now he is like ball Lahiru Perera neme den honda fit Lahiru Perera six pack ekak ema thiyala Lahiru Perera with Lasinho. He's doing something great. And ehema thama mas ekenne every time someone tries to, you know, change the course of music or whatever, you get hate. Pasta is doing a great thing, mas mama Costa, I know him personally. I mean, ekenne me oi industry ek hindama me langa di andura gena, and he's a super nice guy, mas he's very creative. He never said he was a rapper. Wo hadanawa ඌට ඌගේ vibe එකට හරියන සින්දු జాතියක් ඌ හදනවා. And ඒක සමහර මිනිස්සුන්ට set වෙනවා, සමහර මිනිස්සුන්ට set වෙන්නේ නැහැ. ඉතින් set වෙන්නේ නැති උන් ටික බයිනවා, set වෙන්නේ උන් ටික අහනවා.
Hey, I was amazed, Machan, that you can do a song, maybe Batanala song, hip hop song about playing Batanala. Ne,
ekke machan ara sample ekai, and it's patta groovy ne bang ara damma 808 ekak wadinawa natan began wenenawa ne ekata. Yeah, he should, yes, ara ara etokota meka me mokadda uge 20 ekola kiyala ekak thiyenawa hal thiyenawa 20 ekola kiyala thiyenawa machan me ape Amaradeva master ge taru arundhati eke sample karala
ne eka nam
ne, I don't know about the legal background ekada, but song eka patta groovy mas he stripped the sample in a way that we haven't heard before.
Machan, tell me a little bit about I know there's a lot of Sri Lankans in Toronto, right? Sri Lankan is very common there. Have you also came across Filipinos there?
Machan, Filipinos mage yaluwek weda karana issara math ekak Enrique kiyala is the only Filipino I know. Like I know innawa godak innawa kiyala dana personally mata u vitarai Enrique vitarai man danne personally, but there are a lot of Filipinos here.
Oh, Machan, they're kind of similar to I've been living here for like many years now, that almost 15 years now, Machan. They're very close to Sri Lankan kind of vibe. Very, you know, Machan, yeah, they are very relaxed.
Yeah.
And
respecting the elders, gewalwalta adare, gewalwalta salli hamba karala wenawa ape vibe ekane.
Oh, same thing, yeah, machan.
Very nice.
More of Nigambo vibe wage tama. Mokada deya Catholic
ara. Yeah. So do you go back home, machan? Yanawada Lankawada?
Yanawa. I last time I went was 2016. Dan idin me COVID ekka, I don't know when I can go back. Me tama
anamara. ඔව් දැන් යන්න එපා මේ දවස්වල ගෙදරට ලයිට් ද පොඩ්කාස්ට් කර කර ඉන්න ගෙදරට
මචං
එනිපුඩි that's the best thing මචං it's like I ගෙදරට වෙලා ඉදදී වැඩ හොයාගන්න පුළුවන් කරන්න ඕන තරම්
නෑ මචං my background මේකයි I used to go to I started going to concerts මේ 2000 year 2000 first concert හරිද
yeah.
So decade I've been going to concert 20 years already I just celebrated my 20th year. Over machang I probably had attended maybe more than 500 concerts. I think every month my normal thing is I fly to Singapore, Indonesia, Malaysia, or here I watch probably 5-6 concerts every month. I think now may COVID awata passe everything got cancelled, ඊට පස්සේ මචං bloody empty මොකුත් නෑ කරන්න. That's why I started the podcast like 2-3 months ago. Idea came me because I know a lot of bands, I know a lot of people from this going to shows and stuff, so
yeah. No, it's good, man. Like you're bringing in people. I hope, like I watch it, but I hope like our audiences are watching it too, because like na pitrata ek danna nathi ek genawam balanne nae ne ban samanyen ape unda matte mam I got direct text on one of my we shot that for sneaker but mage personal channel ekek man damma
oh
ape un danna nae kawuda direct text kiyanne kiyala ithe edota dan baatiyage episode ekata thiyena nam 20000 views direct text ekata thiyena 7000 I'm not saying anything to like baatiya kema adu wenno oni kiyana neme, but like you bring in someone international and if like your audience doesn't know like their value or like who the hell they are. ඉතින් ඒ එතන මේ පොඩි මේකත් තියෙනවා හැබැයි I hope people actually watch it and like you know discover these amazing musicians who you are bringing on your show.
So Kamaj, anybody you want to shout out to Kamaj?
What I'm shout out to so many people. Gedara set එක තමයි මම මුලින්ම because like for me to do all these extra because podcast karne wa video karne wa okkoma ape then normal jeevithen extra wedane maza.
Oh.
So like the wife takes care of the two kids and the dog and all that and I have like time to do that. So like even when you know even when I got laid off like my wife I think probably has been like the biggest supporter all along. Mokada samahara velada vena wife la kenek kitiyanam madan she would have asked me to find a job right for job security and all that bullshit. But she has so far she has never said anything like that. Do what you love, you enjoy it. Even when you're stressed, even when you're stressed out, it's like okay, if you're stressed out, like when I'm too stressed out for stuff, like go back to a normal job. I'm like, if I go back to a normal job, then I would be stressed out over other people's problems. But now right. I'm stressed out over my problems, so it's fine, Kelvin. So I think like my wife has been the biggest supporter, like right from like the get go. And I met her, Majang, when I had nothing, literally like nothing. I was studied in England. Came back home to Sri Lanka hoping to find a job according to my qualifications. And I'm not, I don't usually go after people asking for things. I hope and pray and I hope for the best thinking that my qualifications will, you know, talk for them for itself, but it usually doesn't unless you know someone in Sri Lanka and ask for something, you don't get anything. That is my mistake, and I don't like to ask people for things for favors. So I was probably one of the lowest periods in my life, I think. I had all these like qualifications from England, and I didn't have a job to show for it. And when you are like 25 and 26, then you get into these other like, you know, things that you probably don't need to get into, like partying and drinking and all. Like, I used to go out like 3, 4, 5 times a night. And like, you drink and then like your body looks like shit and you feel like shit and all those things. And I met my wife then when I had nothing, and she... You know, when you meet someone, when you have nothing, and then, you know, when you build a future or you have a plan and when you build something together, it's actually pretty good. You know, like, they are your ride or die for, like, ever. Unlike Deng, not that I'm saying that I have a lot of money or whatever, I don't. My company is somewhat stable, but I'm still though I own the company, I'm still an employee of the company. So that I don't take more than I need to take, right? If it was now, Mazan, then I would, you know, I would think twice. But I think, yeah, I met her when I had nothing. And, you know, my wife's son, both my parents have passed away, Mazan. So I'm an only child, so I don't have any siblings. My dad's family, my mom's family, all the people, I'm very close to them. Some of them I've actually, you know, rediscovered and, you know, reconnected with them. And now we have this amazing relationship. Because I was product weird. I was never about like, maybe because I was an only child, I was never about like family and connecting with, you know, closer people. And I'm like, okay, I don't need to call these people all the time and all that. But I think I've matured, and obviously you mature and you grow, right? And you know, I am connected to like my family, and I have an amazing network of friends. Not a lot of friends. But you know, Eva, you have to, you know, limit it. All my, you know, day ones, my school friends, and also like my music friends, like Manu, Chika, so we support each other in everything we do. So you build yourself, you know, you surround your people with yourself with the right people, Mazang, your life is good. I think negative, like, and you cut those people out of your life, right? That's what I do.
Oh.
තමයි.
Okay, Kamaj. Thanks for doing this, man. I really enjoyed this conversation.
Yeah, welcome, Masang. All the best to you too as well, and a good job on the podcast. I hope you grow. Lanka minisu meka hondai wedi wedi podcast patang ganna one ekata podcast ahanne
right. Thanks, man. Take care.
Okay, bro. Take care.